in 1938, in October, end of October 1938, we went to the train station. In Berlin, there were perhaps five, six big train stations before we unheard the bomb.
The living room is actually part of a larger body of work, which is dealing with domestic space, memory, the connection between the domestic space and memory, how the arrangement in the house creates some sort of a story or a reality that you can understand or find out or construct out of encountering all those objects. And thinking about the style, the time, and to whom those objects belong to, and so on. And originally, I thought I would make a large-scale drawing of one-to-one scale of the apartment. And in order to do this, I thought I want to work with a three-dimensional space, so not to work according to two-dimensional images, pictures that are found, but to build a three-dimensional space that I could virtually walk in and then choose different angles and therefore be able to reconstruct different angles that will create the apartment or refer to the apartment in the actual exhibition space. So that's how I came to create this virtual computer-generated space. And I wanted to base it on specific apartment, and therefore I started this journey of finding a person that I can interview. So the process started with contacting a lot of organizations and German Jews in Israel that are organizing different groups culturally, and we share cultural activities and often spend a lot of time together. So I could find a few people who are originally from Berlin, who grew up in Berlin as children and came to Israel, and nowadays they are in their 80s. And so I interviewed a few of them, and one of them was Yerin Noam, who before that was called in Berlin Manfred Lambrou, and interviewed him in a few hours. And based on this interview, to create this process. These images. This option of the 3D glasses created this sort of depth or illusionary depth. And also for me it was an option to talk about or to express this accessibility on the one hand that this very simple optical effect offers, but on the other hand, also to feel that it's very limited and very much actually blocking. So you have this maybe invitation to almost step into this three-dimensional space, but you are very much feeling this invitation.
I decided not to give texture to the object, but to stop a moment before. And And as a result, to get to this kind of weird material, which is actually not a material, because it doesn't have references to textures, and it's virtual. So it creates this weird marzipan quality that I thought, yeah, that can be a good expression to this, the virtual aspect of memory, or being non-material and fading.